Hi everybody. No lesson today, but I figured I'd like to do a quick video just to say that I finally released my book called Secrets, The Chords of Alan Holdsworth, and it's available on Amazon Kindle. But if for whatever reason you don't want to buy it that way or you don't want to try to use the Kindle, there are also free apps that you can use, I believe, from Amazon that allows you to look at the book or the ebook without having to own a Kindle. You can do that too. Or if you want, you can email me directly and I'll set up something so I can just send you and email you the PDF directly. So yeah, it's been in the works for about 3 years. I'm finally glad to get it done. I was a little lazy with it because I just wanted to do the part that I know best, which is the chords and the text and all that stuff. And I was hoping to have another publisher, a publisher, pick up the book and then they design the cover and do all that kind of stuff, which I really was not interested in doing. But it got to the point where I know people kept asking me and I felt bad saying soon. So I said, you know what, the hell with it, I'm just going to finally finish it. So I spent this week and I did everything I needed to do and now it's finished. I hope you enjoy it. All the chords that are in there shouldn't really be anything different from if you've watched all these videos. There's actually less chords in it than what you see in the videos because I removed and didn't add a lot of chords that I thought were more common, simpler major triads or major seven chords and stuff like that. It's primarily the more unique voicings that Alan used, and there's about 250 chords in there. So and they're all organized to whether they're major or minor, or if they're part of the Lydian mode and etc. So you can see that all in there. So if you purchase it, I appreciate your support, even if it's a thank you for all these lesson videos that I do. It's appreciated. I just want to get Alan's music out there and so people cannot be as intimidated by it as I was. Which leads me to thinking this might be nice to actually talk about my experience with Alan and how I came to be to doing all these videos. So I don't know where I first heard of Alan. It had to have been like the late 2000s or early, like 1999 or something. I use PowerTab to transcribe all my stuff because I've been using it for so long. And I think I found a pack of all these Alan Holdsworth songs and people doing his transcriptions. And it just sounded like nonsense because remember, I'm really not a jazz guy. I just enjoy music regardless of what genre it is. So I really wasn't a traditional jazz guy. So, you know, obviously having a little bit more of a jazz knowledge and appreciation, you can understand his improvisation style. But it just sounded like nonsense. Also, the transcriptions were probably wrong and all that kind of stuff. So I didn't get it, but I knew this was a guy that was really good. Then eventually, about 2006, started to work at Sam Mash on Long Island, and I started to get a little bit more serious about the instrument. So I got his instructional video and his instructional book, and I looked through it, and he's very egocentric of me. I was like, I know what he's doing, I got his concepts, it's very simple. Which, it actually is very simple, but it was very flippant of me to just sort of write it off like I knew what was going on. Because I was looking for something, I guess, more on the surface level when his stuff is actually much more deeper. So anyway, that was about 2006, 2007, and eventually in 2009, I saw that he was playing in Huntington at the IMAC Theater, and what's great is that this show is pretty easy to find online if you look for live Alan stuff. So I was at that show, and at the point I only knew the songs from his instructional video, Protocosmos and Looking Glass. So when I saw him, I didn't know any of the songs that he was playing. I just wanted to be there. I didn't know anything that he was playing, but it was sort of like, I kind of knew once I get it, I'm going to love it, so I might as well see it now. And at the time, I still didn't get it. I wanted to experience this person's command of the instrument, something that I aspired to do myself. And he ended up playing Protocosmos, which I recognize. But there was a piece there, his solo swell stuff. I remember his tone was so massive, it like engulfed me. And there hasn't been many times where I've seen a band where I felt that I was actually moved. And that was one of those times. And I'm glad that that moment is sort of captured on video. So I remember seeing him. I enjoyed it. I remember that day actually very well. Got a funny story for that. But then that was it. And actually during my time at Sam Ash, I noticed that he had a clinic at the Sam Ash that I work at. And I remember going in and yelling at my friend Peter, because as Alan was playing, he was paging over the PA. He said, "How dare you page while Alan's playing?" So that was, you know, 2009, 2010. But then I sort of got off of the Alan stuff, and then eventually decided to get back into it and listen to it, saying, "Oh, you know what? It's time to give this guy a chance." And I still didn't get it. It sounded like nonsense to me. So I had a friend of mine, Eric Wollman, where he was a big Alan, he still is a big Alan fan, and I remember talking to him about that, and he said a couple things that were really interesting about Alan playing very diatonically, because I kept telling him that, "Oh, the solos just sound like random noise, I don't get it." So I went back and I listened to it, and it just clicked. Finally, I was able to I was listening to the songs wrong. I was listening to it in a way that made it sound, everything was sort of random, but I wasn't paying attention to the top note of the chord was really the melody, and paying attention to what Alan's playing against the chord that's underneath it. And then it just all came to me. I said, "This is great, now I get it." And I remember gushing to him about it. So then I decided, well, I should learn some songs. This was probably 2016. So I started to learn a few songs, and I started to see some similarities between other songs. One of the first ones I learned was Looking Glass. One of the first I transcribed was Last May off of Velvet Darkness. But then I wanted to learn House of Mirrors, which is in his instructional video. So as I learned a few songs, I started to see chords that were similar. And my ignorance about Alan was, this guy just knows every chord, every song has a million different chords, they're all different, you'll never be able to learn them all. And it's almost like gatekeeping yourself in a way, because you get intimidated, you don't even want to try. So as I started to see some similarities, I remember I went to him and I mentioned it to him. And I decided to keep on learning, and I said, you know what, I'm going to start just transcribing a bunch of his material. So I did, and then Alan passed in 2017, which really upset me, because it reminded me of when I was 10 years old. If anyone can see, I got my Nirvana Incesticide poster up there. There was the first band that I really got into, and I remember getting Nevermind and In Utero for my 10th birthday in March of 94, and then a month later, he committed suicide. So I never got the chance to really see that band while I was really into them. So when Alan passed, it upset me to go, this is a guy that now I'm starting to really get and appreciate, and now I can't see him live or even, you know, talk to him or ask him some questions. So this really lit a fire under me in terms of wanting to learn more and transcribing this stuff. And the passion that I got again from playing the guitar was something that was missing for quite a few years. I was kind of upset with where I was with my playing. I wasn't enjoying it anymore. So all these videos that I do is pretty much my way of being able to tell Alan, thank you for making me a better musician and appreciating this stuff. And I guess it's sort of my mission in a way to get people to learn his music and not be so intimidated by it. So with these lesson videos that I'm doing and the ebook that I put out, they're all kind of that mindset of don't be so intimidated. There are some things that are really hard in there, but the beauty is that the concept is really simple and you can really make it your own. And that's really about it. So that was kind of my journey to where I am now. So I appreciate a lot of you guys for being on this ride with me. I got only a few songs left that I'm going to do for this series, and then that's it. I mean, I've done as much as I could. So anyway, thanks a lot for joining me. If you buy the book, I appreciate that, and I'll see you guys soon.